Hello dear students, in this chapter 7, Changing Cultural Tradition, you are learning the knowledge on the transition of people's experience and life from old into new. This is called the Renaissance, getting something new from old to new. This Renaissance thinking came in a very greater impact on the life of human beings. That's why I have taken the subtopic called New Concept of Human Beings. Why do I say new concept? Because according to the old concept, it was said that human beings were created by God. Whatever suffering would come, they should tolerate in the name of God, because that was their destiny. According to the new concept, the humanist thinkers began to preach that each individual is responsible for his own development of life. Development of the individuals do not depend on God, but on the work of the individuals themselves. This is a new thinking. If the individuals are working honestly and hard, they will get profit and benefit. If not, they ought to suffer. Not by virtue of sin, but by virtue of laziness or by virtue of any other poor activities. This is the change. In Italy, there was a writer, his name was called Lorenzo Valla. Lorenzo Valla, he wrote a book called On Pleasure. Through this book, Lorenzo was trying to tell the people that people have got the right to enjoy wealth. They should work for it, they should enjoy it. In the name of God, they ought not to suffer long. This is a new way of thinking of human life, Renaissance of thinking on human life. Therefore, individuals are capable to build their own life by their own work. Related to this story of the human beings, I like to give a special stress on the life of women in Europe. I like to divide the life of the human women into two categories. One is called the women of aristocratic family, and another category of women I like to place them called merchant family. The women who belong to the aristocratic family, their life was something different than the women of merchant family. Women, those who were born in the aristocratic family, they were married to aristocratic family. Married to aristocratic family boy. These women were not allowed to come out of their house. They were not allowed to take part into any public activity or discussion. In the aristocratic family, whatever the boy or the husband did, that was the final work. Husband dominated family, even though the women were from the rich or aristocratic family. Whatever husband took the decision, women had no say on it. Not only that, these women of the aristocratic family did not, or could not, or were not allowed to give any opinion. These women in the aristocratic family were taken as worker within the household. Domestic area they should be staying. They should look after the household work only. Household work. That was their area of the world. Not allowed to come out. Not allowed to participate in any public speech. Not even they were allowed to take the share from their parent and family. Not only that, most of the time the women of the aristocratic family were not allowed to go for education. This was how the restricted life of women were there in spite of the spread of humanistic idea. Okay. I will take you to the other group of women of merchant family. In this merchant family, their life was much opposite compared to the aristocratic family women. This merchant family were allowed to come out to the open to do the public work. Not only that, merchant family, when the merchants were away for the business to some other area, their women looked after the domestic business. This is something different than the life of the aristocratic women. In the merchant family, when a woman became widow, she took care of the business of her husband, one who was dead. So if we go in this pattern, we can understand the women of the merchant family was much more liberal than the controlled life of the women in the aristocratic family. Now, my dear children, when this type of restriction was there, especially on the women of the aristocratic family, what happened, you know? There were some women who were very intelligent, very powerful, very bold to protest against this type of prison-like life of the aristocratic family. One of such women was named Fedele. Fedele. She was from the city of Venice in Italy. She was intelligent. She was a very good orator. She privately equipped herself with her knowledge of Latin and Greek. Therefore, she was an educated woman. She protested against the controlled life of the aristocratic family. She wanted that every woman should be given freedom to move out, should get a share of the parental family, should participate in the public debate, should give opinion as a partner of the husband in the family, should give opinion to the certain tricky areas and important decision of the family. She protested. In this way, my dear children, there were some women who tried to break the ghetto mentality of the aristocratic family and fought for freedom of the women. When the human beings where as men or women were having this type of protocol, what was the impact of religion on them? Impact on religion. I told you in my previous lectures that people were told to obey everything as if coming from the God and accept good or bad. But by virtue of the spread of humanistic ideas, people began to now question the activity of the church. What church? Catholic Church. Catholic Church means the work of the clergymen. These clergymen, in the name of religion, they were practically exploiting the common category of people or poorer category of people. They were collecting tax. Church was collecting tax, means clergymen were collecting tax. They were preaching that the human beings were sinful. In order to get redemption from the sin, if the people would buy one indulgence, then their sin would be forgiven. What is indulgence? Indulgence was a paper certificate which the people could buy, and after buying that certificate, their certain quantity of sins would be forgiven. But in another language, through the sale of indulgence, church was collecting money. When this way, in the name of God, extortion was going on, there was a priest, his name was called Martin Luther. He was a Catholic priest. He protested this type of selfish collection of money. Martin Luther preached to the people that in order to get the blessing of God, money was not necessary. Rituals were not necessary. What was necessary? According to him, it is a simple obedience to God through prayer to get his blessing. For that, no mediation was required. Anybody could come in touch with God through his humble prayer, through his humble heart, piety, sincerity, simplicity. This type of preaching of Martin Luther affected and was taken up by a large number of people, that a new religion in Christianity was born called Protestant religion. Protestant religion. Many people in different countries in Europe began to take up the theory of Martin Luther and the campaign propagation of Protestantism spread. When this Protestant religion began to be accepted and spread in a larger area, then the Catholic Church got a jerk and shock. Therefore, in order to rectify its position, Catholic Church started another campaign that is called counter movement. Through this counter movement, the Catholic Church began to take up the work to serve the poor. Then they began to ignore collection of taxes. They began to spread the word of God, word of Jesus Christ, in such a way that a lot of changes took place in the Catholic Church. In this way, my dear boys and girls, the knowledge of humanism even changed the mindset of the people to believe in God, not through the means of material ways, but through the spiritual ways. My dear children, this is the most striking change of religious attitude from the Orthodox Catholic dominating Catholic Church into a very social and democratic secular manner of development of religion is something great. Read the book again and I'm sure you will prosper in it. Thank you very much.